Hello, welcome to Bear Talk. I'm Bear, a product designer who lives in Auckland, New Zealand. A few weeks ago, I did a surprise for my team that I'm working with. I doodled everyone's face into a cartoon avatar and then share with the team with different styles and colors, and everyone just loved it. So how did I do it? In this video, I'm going to share you how. The first thing I did is to map out who I'm going to draw. So I blocked around half a day for me to draw them and then use the time to update all the doodles into Figma and then try to make it as a component. So first thing is to prepare the tool. So I have basically two devices, a laptop and an iPad, and also I got an Apple Pencil, which is something that I use to draw. So first, and also I've got two tools on my device. First is the Procreate on iPad, and the other one, Figma. So as a daily use the tool that for product designer. So at first, I map out all the people that I'm going to draw, and then I create a board in Figma, and then input it into this board. So here you can see that I put a grid into that Procreate document, and from here I can see, oh, there are 23 people I want to draw. And then I can time box the time I'm going to spend on drawing. And then I just find their thumbnail on Slack or somewhere so that I can start to draw them and try to capture their their feeling and their style. And also one thing that's really helpful is to define just one pen that I'm using for drawing. This is my customized brush in Procreate. And then happy drawing, happy doodling. After that, I create another different layer so that I can use a white color to fill behind this ink layer. So in this step, one thing you might notice that it's over, like it's a little bit oversized. So just cross the edge. So I'm doing this for purpose because later I might turn those icons, those avatars, into dark mode. So with a field black. So if I 100% follow the edge, and because it will be filled with dark, so probably it's not looks that good. So yeah, that's that's the Procreate step. So create a layer with ink and create a layer with fill, and then I export it to as a PNG document, and then import it into Figma. Now let's jump to Figma. So at first, here I create this layer, and by each of them, I crop the document. So you can see it from here. This is me there, and if I open it, you can see it's like an image, but it was cropped with a rectangle, with a square. so that is nicely in the middle, and then I adjust the position. So by doing that, I put everyone into the same frame. And the interesting part is that I create two components in Figma. So the first one square, the second one round, it's the component I can change the background, the color or other things, and then adapt every thumbnail with the same style. So quite common for product design. So you can see this component with a rectangle, and if I fill the rectangle, currently it's just not visible, but if I turn it on, it fills with black. And also if I change the color into different colors, it will change the thumbnail. So it's a really cool feature that Figma provides as a component. So after that, I just create round avatars and square avatars, and then detach the component and copy it to another page that is ready for download, and then share the link with the team that people can start to select anyone they prefer and download and change their thumbnail on Slack or any other places. So the result is really, really good. I quite like this this exercise because it's like a fun project, and I think it's really good to bond the team in a visual way and a funny way. And also, this is something I can do, and I'm happy to do that for other members of the team. So yeah, hope that's interesting and helpful for you, and maybe insightful that can inspire some ideas that you might able to create for your team. And for the next step, I might able to create some cards for each of the team members. Yeah, that's me on this video. I hope you like it. If you don't, watch another video. Right, so I'm there. Nice to see you on this one, and hope to see you in next video. Ciao.